Welcome to the Tuesday, March 12th, 2013 edition of Erner Barry's Daily Video, sponsored by the NAMP Meat Buyer's Guide Online. In today's video, one of the largest seafood shows in the U.S. is being held in Boston, and Erner Barry is there to see what's happening on the floor. And later, we discuss this week's inventory and market trends in the egg market as we approach Easter. Now let's look at the markets with your host, Jamie Chadwick.
According to the USDA and the USMEF, the first month of 2013 offered a mix of good news and challenges for exports of U.S. beef and pork during January. Yeah. Beef exports continued the trend shown in 2012 with higher export values on lower volumes, while pork exports improved slightly from December's levels but remained behind year-ago totals. Led by sharply higher exports to Hong Kong, Canada, and Taiwan, a solid growth to Japan, beef exports for January rose 9.3% in value from year-ago levels on slightly lower volumes. An overabundance of domestic pork in South Korea is driving down demand for imports there, while China's aggressive efforts to build its domestic pork industry appear to be bearing fruit as its need for imports declines. To read more about red meat exports and for other center-of-the-plate protein news, head over to foodmarket.com. In other news, today is the last day of the International Boston Seafood Show, and here to give us a look at what's happening at the event, here is Seafood.com News staff writer John Sacton.
Remember, 2 years ago, there was some sense of shortage of product, and the buyers at the Seafood Show were extremely eager to sign contracts, to secure deals, and we described it very much as a seller's show, because there was an upward momentum on the part of almost everybody who was participating. This year, we also see some tight supplies and some issues of short supply in species like cod. Like shrimp and like salmon. Cod, of course, is the opposite case. But also, prices have come up recently on salmon, on shrimp, even tilapia. And as a result, we're seeing today a standoff, because the producers see risks of higher prices down the road. They see a risk of higher replacement costs. They're seeing very light inventories and tightness on some products. And unlike 2 years ago, the food service buyers in particular are feeling very cautious. And so nobody really wants to commit at the current price levels, and the net result is a big standoff.
To wrap up today's video, egg market reporter Brian Moscageri discusses this week's inventory and market trends in the egg market as we approach the Easter holiday.
Yesterday's national shell egg inventory was reported by the USDA to be 1,192.7 thousand cases, up 2.9% from last week's figure, and is up 1.1% from the same week before Easter last year. Breaking inventory is down 3.9% this week, totaling 252.3 thousand cases, and is also down 4.8% compared to the same period before the holiday last year. The total shell egg inventory is 1,445 thousand cases, climbing 1.7% this week, and remains about unchanged from this period prior to Easter last year. Retail demand has improved to a good level as buyers begin to build inventory for anticipated movement leading up to the 31st. Wholesale traders have trouble at times to source full need on the open market as sellers continue to confidently hold supplies. Buyers are forced to pay premiums to secure their needs, and the market has been steadily higher since the beginning of March. Most anticipate these conditions will continue, though prices are nearing levels which have motivated some sellers to sign deals. Others are unwilling to let go of product until a clearer picture of Easter movement develops.
Thanks, Brian. That concludes today's video. Thanks for watching and have a great day.
Today's video is sponsored by the NAMP Meat Buyer's Guide Online, an interactive way for you to learn and understand more about the items you buy and sell. The NAMP Meat Buyer's Guide Online features high-definition videos for all of your major red meat items. Head to meatbuyersguide.com to view a demo and sign up today.